Good morning and welcome back to the channel. It is Friday. It is the end of the week. We've made it, guys and girls. We've made it. We're there. So I've got slightly less time to make video today than I do usually, which is why I did the old mixtape yesterday. That was a bit of an epic getting through that. But today I want to revisit Ren, which is it's probably the most interesting and exciting and vital music that I've discovered for a long, long time. It has just really, I suppose, given me a sense of a rehabilitation in music, in modern music making, because up to a point you get very sort of disheartened by what is being churned out by the music industry. Now, I know obviously on this channel we sort of are fairly niched into what we listen to, and actually it's good stuff. There is a lot of good stuff going on, but to hear something outside of the genres that we normally listen to on here, which is sort of namely your prog, your rock, your metal, your jazz, your fusion, that sort of stuff, to hear something completely outside that area of expertise. I mean, I'm guessing still sort of going to be sort of this street rapping stuff, and it's I just don't have expertise enough to be able to sort of break it down and commentate about it. But what I do know is it sounds amazing, and I can absolutely appreciate the talent of what he's doing and how he's doing it. So far on the channel, obviously, we've listened to Hi Ren, which absolutely just floored me. And I think it did with everybody who's listened to it. That's been borne out in the comments. I also listened to, a few weeks ago, the cover of War Pigs with the Big Push when he was doing the street busking. And of those two videos, it's just given me a breadth of understanding of where he's coming from musically and what he's able to do. One of the most requested and spoken about sets of videos, because it is a set of videos, after talking about Hi Ren and listening to that, was the Tale of Jenny and Screech, which is what we're going to do today. This is actually, I think it's three videos in the end, because we've got another one on the end called Violet's Tale. So we've got the Tale of Jenny, the Tale of Screech, and Violet's Tale, or Tale of Violet. I can't remember what it's called, but it's all just put together as one long thing. So with a bit of luck, it should all sort of play through without any issues and problems. Now, do I want to say anything else? I don't know if I do. I think probably just want to sort of get on and listen to it. So that's what we should do. I've got it lined up over here. Got another camera there. Don't know if we're going to use it too much, but I've got it. Here we go. So, 3, 2, 1. That's not right, is it? 3, 2, 1. Like a dusty bin. If you can remember that, you're older than me. Right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Bosh. God rest ye merry gentlemen. Back streets of Brighton.
It was a quiet, dark night in an empty street somewhere in London City. Jenny walked alone, she was dragging her feet. She was heading back home to sleep. Well, she knew this town, she knew this floor, because she walked it about 1,000 times before she wanted to escape. Can you blame? Well, on the very same night, in a different place, there walked this hooded young youth by the name of James. He was 14 years old and out of his brain. He'd been smoking ganja with the boys. James, he grew up to be a kid of the street. His mates called him Screech, he was quick on his feet. He was a liar, a thief, at 14 years old. The devil had set his sights on his soul. As Jenny walked home all alone, she felt scared. Usually she was alright, but it was like there was something in the air. A divine intervention telling her to beware, maybe intuition bogging her and making her so scared. Sirens sounded in the distance to the beat of Jenny's feet. A symphony of the night that echoes crime on London streets. Jenny turns a corner, their eyes they meet. Our poor girl Jenny, a boy named Screech. Give me all your money, bitch, give it to me. If you cooperate, then you'll soon be free. I want your purse, your phone, don't fucking look at me. I mean it, bitch, are you listening to me? Jenny freezes statue like a lady shakes stalactite. Feel like liquid nitrogen in the dark night. She tried to find strength to move, but stayed as still as a statue in high-heeled shoes. What the hell you playing now? You playing games with me? I swear to fucking God, I'll slice the rosy off your cheeks. You think I don't mean it, girl? You don't know me. The last thing you see will be a boy called Screech. Reached with the sheath of the blade, with the teeth that could bite through steel and slice concrete. And he swung possessed with the devil in his chest, and the statue she was turned to butter in her breath.
Who know?
It was a quiet dark night in an empty street somewhere at London City. Jenny lay still on the cold concrete. She's found somewhere to sleep. Well, she knew this town, she knew this floor, cause she'd walked it about 1,000 times before. I guess that she escaped. It's such a shame.
Sad tale. So pointless. Well. No. I'm just going to let this run through. I'm not going to pause it as we go.
Let me in, please open the door. I think I fucked up Patrick, really fucked up, man, I'm not sure. I got crazy, left this lady lying still on the floor. I think I killed her, Patrick, come on, man, I can't knock no more. But Screech kept on knocking till his knuckles became sore. But there's no sign of Patrick down at number 54. No refuge for our villain, for the bitter hands of fate, with something far more sinister in mind that does away.
This is so different. So different from the last two things we've listened to.
Hey, babe. You in? Nah, nothing really. I'm just a bit tired. Listen, can I swing around yours for a few moments? I just really miss you, babe. What the fuck do you mean you're busy? You fucking bitch! For fuck's sakes! Siren sounds approaching like a banshee in the night. The shrill cry of justice cutting like the sharpest knife. But Screech was never one to run, not one to miss a fight. One hand upon his blade, he turned to face the blue lights. Come on then, you fucking cunts, let's fucking have you then. I am Screech, I'm the boss, I'm the ender of men. You think that uniform you're wearing means that you own these streets? These are my fucking streets, and they call me fucking Screech. Richard was an officer who stood at 6'3". Work in London on the night shift, what he didn't think he'd see was a boy running at him like an animal possessed. With no time to hesitate, he fired 4 bullets at Screech's chest.
Oh, God. This is so well done.
Our story, it ends right at the start. Young Screech and poor Jenny lying 1 street apart. An officer shaken by the boy that he claimed. 2 bodies lay lifeless. And it's such a shame. It's such a shame.
Tragic it is. That's what it is. It's tragic. Wow. It's coming out like a sort of a story from a crime thriller. It's really, really well written. Violence tale.
Far from pretty, 2005. A lady down in Paddington is fighting just to stay alive. Rhythmic beeps and bloodstained sheets. Our lady weeps, she's tired and frail. To set the scene, we must rewind the hands of time for Violet's tale. Silent girl grew up with violent starts. Ooh. Her mother was a drinker and her father was a bastard. Every night she took her tie, but never left the room. I'll spare you of the things he did, I'm sure her mother knew. Violet was a silent girl, she moved out at 16. A semi-detached council flat, paid for by a welfare scheme. Packing shelves at Tesco, stacking jars like pickled bricks. She met a boy named Stevie and he was a little prick. Violet was a silent girl and Violet, she fell fast. See, Stevie was a wrong un, but he sure knew how to charm her. Every night he took her tie, but never left the room. History repeats itself, he'd paint her black and blue and dark.
These are such sad, dark stories.
She never stood a chance. The devil comes to dance.
Violet, why are you always so quiet? on her bedroom door and he's irate. He's been drinking and smoking, he's up late. And he stands by her bedside, she shakes, but her eyes stay shut. You fucking slut, I know you're up. And he pinches her eyelids and folds them up. Violet, why are you lying to me, Violet? She stays silent, things turn violent. That's the sound of his fists when they fall like a crashing pilot. Hit like hailstones, one to the collarbone, full force, full blown, blood splat, bone crack, knick-knack, paddywhack, one to the jaw and the tooth spat, detached, fist connects and disconnects a bone. A quick deflect to misdirect the blow, but nonetheless his punches met her throat. Such a mess he's left her bruised and broke. Violet, why are you always so silent, Violet? Why are you such a little liar, Violet? Do you think I want to do this, Violet? In character, she stays silent. Well, say something, Violet. Silence. Fucking say something, Violet. Silence. Wait. Say something, Violet. Not one word. She stays quiet. London City, far from pretty, 2005. A lady down in Paddington is fighting just to stay alive. The doctor, in a state of shock, saw something here so very wrong. See, Violet, she was pregnant. Poor Violet, she was 9 months gone. Turning to the doctor, Violet broke her silence and she cried, if I'm to die right here tonight, please let my baby stay alive. The doctor soon regained composure, called the surgeon to come in. As Violet's world turned to black, the curtains closed, the lights went dim. In London City, far from pretty, 2005, a lady down in Paddington just lost the fight to stay alive. A tragedy or a miracle, it happened on these very streets. Two twins are lying side by side.
No way. Is it going to be?
A girl named Jenny.
Yes. Oh, you.
A boy named
genius.
Screech.
Absolute fucking genius, mate. Oh. Oh. Oh, man. I'm slightly overwhelmed and overcome by that. That's, God. What an imagination. What an imagination. What a raconteur he is. Incredible storytelling. And I've... It's sort of kind of almost in the sort of... I know people have talked about it as being Shakespearean. I'm not quite sure. I mean, maybe it is, but it's as in it's an unexpected twist at the end. But it's kind of the storytelling almost in the style of sort of Arlo Guthrie. You know, we listened to that back in the end of last year. Or was it New? I can't remember. What it was New Year's, around New Year. Alice's Restaurant. So just this sort of long... drawn, I mean, that was really funny, whereas this is just absolutely tragic. It's an absolute tragedy of a story. But what a genius plot twist. Absolutely genius plot twist. I can't get over that these kids were 14, that Screech was 14 when he did this, which means that Jenny must have been 14 as well. I'm not sure Jenny, as a 14... Maybe this is a... I'm sort of disconnected from sort of that age group now because I'm so much older. I'm a very old man. I suppose when I was 14, I wasn't sort of roaming the streets with a knife. Then again, I didn't live in London. My niece is 14, and that worries me that that is the life that could be just around any corner at any time for her who lives in London. I have to say, though, just the not necessarily the music of it. It's not even that sophisticated. It's just absolutely brilliantly playing for the piece, for the for the storytelling. It's all about the story. It's all about the words and the flow of them and the rhyming and the reveal. Each one just comes to a little climax. It's like, oh, man, what a thing. And then before you know it, this, you've got to the next one. It's even sort of an even bigger sort of reveal. And then that bit at the end, and literally just cut off, it's finished. Wow. Absolutely phenomenal stuff. As I've said before, there's nothing sort of off limits on the channel. I will listen to anything, and I do listen to anything and everything. And there's very, very little music that I sort of don't like. I can find something sort of positive to say about. So sort of hip hop and rap is sort of an area I don't really sort of delve into very much. There's a little bits and pieces here and there, but it's not really being an area that has drawn me in. And I suspect that had he not been such a great wordsmith, I probably wouldn't have been drawn into this as much. But I think it's just literally, I'm saying genius. I think it is. It's the genius of the storytelling and of the authenticity of it. It feels real. It feels real because he's placed himself in the street doing it. He's in the back street. It's filmed in Brighton, but it could be anywhere. As I said, and it's meant to be set in London. But it feels raw and gritty and absolutely real. I was going to say about the in Screech's video. Was it Screech? No, it's the last one. It's Violet's Tale. When he stood up from the hospital bed and started walking around the room playing the guitar and started speaking, singing, you could suddenly realise that this absolutely is being done in one take. This is not an overdub. It's not just a video with the music playing in the background, because the vocal changed as soon as he walked out into the hallway. You've got all the hard surfaces in there, so you get the reflections back. You get that really strong echo, and it is absolutely revealed. So there was no way that could have been hidden, and that was a really lovely thing to hear, to know that this is actually being done. It's not just filming a video with a tape playing in the background of the music. He was playing it and he's singing it live as it's going on. Just absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Well done, Ren. You've done it again. You've done it again. So that's three down. A lot more to go. But I'm so excited to hear more of what he's doing and what he's done. I understand he's actually in Canada at the minute getting some treatment for his various illnesses, specifically the autoimmune thing. So hopefully that's going well and he'll be back in the UK sort of in due course. But there we go. Wow. Hey. Lightman, you asked for that one specifically. You kept sort of going on and on and on. Not on and on, I don't mean that. But I want to say thank you for mentioning that in the comments, and for everybody else who's recommended and suggested it. I've enjoyed it. It's more than enjoyed it. I've been absolutely blown away by it. Yeah, it's fantastic stuff. Hope you have too. I hope you've enjoyed it. I'll see you guys on the next video, whenever and whatever that is. And until then, this is Jim over.